Meanwhile, voters in Denver have just a little more than 24 hours to get those ballots in as the city prepares to select a new mayor. Get this, for the first time in 12 years.
It's been a while. Fox 31 political reporter Gabrielle Franklin caught up with the candidates and their supporters today to see how they're getting ready for the runoff results. Gabrielle.
Yeah, Jeremy, supporters of both candidates are doing some last-minute stumping today, so we caught up with both sides to see how they're trying to garner some more votes before tomorrow night.
Vote for Kelly Brough, ready to be our next mayor of Denver.
The campaigns for mayoral candidates Kelly Brough and Mike Johnston were out in full force Monday, trying to sway last-minute voters to cast those ballots. We connected with supporters backing each candidate.
I've known Kelly since she started with the city as an intern in the personnel office. Matter of fact, I hired her. I know her to be truthful, honest, having integrity, will listen.
I went to an event for Mike. I went to an event for Kelly. I had coffee with, all of them, actually, in addition to that.
A significant amount of voters have already made their choice.
We are at a little over 21% right now. Compared to April, we were at about 15%. So we're definitely trending higher than a couple months ago. But, you know, we'll have to see. It could just be that folks have turned in theirs earlier, and we might see roughly the same turnout. We might see more turnout, something that might look a little bit more comparable to the 2019 runoff.
Almost 166,000 ballots were returned that year. We asked supporters why last-minute voters should pick their candidates this time around.
She's not supported by outside money, and that's a biggie to me, especially being a longtime Denver resident. I think her stance on some of the issues, knowing her for so long, knowing who she is, knowing that we're headed for a mayor with transparency, commitment, integrity, that's what I want in my city.
Quite honestly, Kelly was my runner-up. I really liked her on a personal level. I thought she was a genuine, kind person. But she's too conservative for Denver, just straight out. She opposed paid family leave at the chamber. She opposed raising the minimum wage and still did as of earlier this year. She is someone who will stand up for the business interests in this city.
So remember, if you are still holding on to those ballots, you have until 7 p.m. tomorrow night to turn them in and let your voice be heard. Reporting live outside the Denver Clerk and Recorder's Office, Gabrielle Franklin, Fox 31.